Hello, guys. Welcome back with me, Chow Chow 2025. Today, we're going to learn about face swap in real time. We are going to use Live Portrait in Comfy UI. We're going to use KJ Node. How to install it for the first time, you could see in the link on video description. Also, KJ Live Portrait GitHub also in video description. If you already have one, try updating it first. Now, let's get started. Go to KJ GitHub, select example, click Live Portrait, real-time example 01. Save the workflow and put anywhere you like. Now back to Comfy. Load the workflow JSON file that you saved before. If you still have some red node, go to manager. Click install missing custom nodes. Click install or update for the missing node. Restart after the command show up. Do it for all the red node. After that, in load image, select or upload picture that you want to use as a new face. Set up the size accordingly. For Live Portrait load media pipe cropper, select what you want. You can use CPU, CUDA, Torch, and other. Each will download its own model. Webcam Capture CV2 will be the one which called the webcam picture. If it's not show your com picture, change the index. Use preview image if you're not sure, and connect it with image from webcam capture. You could also use ScreenCap MSS. It will capture image from the screen. So if some, how you could show your com on the screen or other image or video on the screen. You could also use that. Use preview image to make sure. In this video, I add rotate image because my picture in landscape. After that, I also resize image to get a square result. Non-square result will make a picture look strange. Anyway, you could queue manually. Or if you want to automatically queue, use extra option. Use auto queue. Select instant. This will make comfy queue for every change you make. Since you use webcam, every move will trigger this. Here are the results. Also, if you want to increase the FPS, increase the batch, depending on your PC speed. This could be good or bad. If you see the queue couldn't handle the speed, start reducing it. You could use OBS to put the result in your video, and then make it as a camera source with OBS virtual camera. Anyway, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.